good morning once again. This is Pastor Robert of Covenant Life Church Indonesia. You're watching Covenant Life Church Indonesia for our Sunday service, and this is our morning prayer time. I thank you that you are here with us today, joining us in our morning prayer. Thank you so much. For my CLC family, thank you so much for being there always, you know, joining us as we make our petitions made known to God. So as for everybody, those of you who are not from CLC, every Sunday morning at 9:30, we start our service. So I do invite you, please come on time 9:30 and let us join together in prayer as we start our Sunday service. And I really do thank you so much for joining us today. I know this is not an accident that you're here, because the Lord has a purpose and the Lord has a word for you today. So stay tuned and always join us in prayer as we start our Sunday service. So let us all put together, let us all be one in spirit, let us be in a unison, one body, as we continue and as we make our prayers or petitions known unto God. So He promised in His word that two or three that is gathered in His name, He is always in our midst. I know we are gathered online, but the word of the Lord still holds true. He is in our midst, because time and distance is irrelevant to God. Okay, He's everywhere. So as we gather together and as we pray as one and make our petitions and prayers made known to Him, trust and believe that He is in our midst. Okay, so let us all start. Let us be one in spirit and in truth as we start our service. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for this very wonderful Sunday morning that we can gather together as one body, one in you, O God. Lord, Holy Spirit, we thank you that you are always there leading and guiding us, and always there ministering to us, O God. Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for everything that you have done and for everything that you will do in us and through us. Jesus, oh Lord, thank you so much for giving your life so that I may live. For giving your life that I will be reunited back to the Father, because I'm forgiven. Thank you so much for your faithfulness. Oh, you're faithful, you're faithful, you're faithful. Always has been and always will be. Thank you so much, oh Father. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, we thank you for your word. We thank you that your promises is yes and amen to your people, that your promises always holds true, because you are a God who never lies. Whatever you say will be true. So we thank you that you love each and every one of us. Lord, we also thank you that we will not be careful for nothing, but instead, in everything by prayer, everything by supplication with thanksgiving, we will make our requests be made known unto you. Because we know, God, that you are there listening to us. Oh, we thank you that as you promise, that as we continue to abide in you, and your words will abide in us, that we can ask whatever we will, and it shall be done unto us. Father, our faith is in you. Our trust is in you. So, Father, whatever the petitions that we have for you, whatever that is our need, whatever the cry of our hearts, I believe in the name of Jesus that you are answering our prayers. Father, we thank you that you are always there for your people, that you're always there for me, that you're always there for every one of us. Oh, I thank you in everything, oh God. I thank you because everything has its meaning. Everything will always turn for good to those who love you. Thank you so much, Father. Thank you for the privilege and the opportunity to follow and serve you. Father, my life is yours. My life is yours. My life is yours. Use it, God. Use it for your greater glory and honor. My life is yours. Lord, I believe that all of us here who's gathered in prayer, I believe that all of us has given up our life, has offered our life to you. So, Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you use our lives, that we can bring more greater glory and greater honor to you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for this opportunity to serve you. Thank you for this privilege to follow you. Thank you so much for everything. Oh, we thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Oh, we thank you. O shakandali inderas tande. O shinde kamla mahandalim brabasundu. Rikrim brabasu kumble brama masande. Lord, we thank you that whatever things we desire, when we pray, and when we put our faith and believe that we receive them, and we shall have them. So, Father, we make our petitions known to you now. You know what are the cries of our hearts. We lay down at your feet. We believe with our hearts that you are answering our prayers even as we pray right now. And we receive it, Father, in the name of Jesus. We receive it in the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you. Oh, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Oh, Shandalahandelish de Kimbra Matanesta, Limbrosu Kumbra Masende Kimbra Baba Basuko, O Lembrishin de Kimbra Brahmasende, O Lishikimbra Handalastende, Rimbra Mama Masukula Ma and Eri Shikim Yahande, Limbrosu Kumbra Masende Kimbra Brahmande. Shikim lebrama masende kim lebranda lishtiki. Rikim brama masundu kumbra baba basu kumbra mande. Thank you, Jesus, that as we call unto you, you will answer us. And you will show us your goodness. You will show us your faithfulness. Even beyond what we know of, oh God. That your faithfulness is far more greater than what we already have experienced. That your goodness and your miracles and your provisions are far more than what we could ever imagine. Because you love your people. And your plan for them is to prosper us, to bring us hope and a future. Oh, we thank you, Father. Oh, shalachim ra'amishta achamagande, li'isht amlakande li'ishtu kumbra masende, ru'umlandi ra'ishta mahakanda li'ishti kimbra nalayei, hushukumbra maskanda limbra basaka, undishta madanite mashta kalandiyana, li'ikenda ishta kala ashtum blokunda linianash, limleshti ikambra hasta, likim londo stumbrane kindi nisht kimya handa kandesti, rumlanda stumbrane kina anda lista kini anda kambunde, rumlo suku, rime hini shinda makandestum blonda la kande, o ridestu monda di da matanestaka, lindestu man umrosu kumbra maande, rihim la mushundo kumbra masande. Rambrama masuko rambrama masande. Oh, we thank you for your faithfulness. Because your faithfulness to your people has preserved us. That as we put our faith and trust in you, your faithfulness has preserved us, has blessed us. That as we put our trust in you, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. We become the head and not the tail. We are above and not beneath. We are no longer servants, but we become sons and daughters. Your sons and daughters. Because your faithfulness makes all your promises yes and amen for us. Because of your faithfulness, we can feast in the midst of our enemy. Because you are there with us. Because you are the one who sets the table for us. That I can walk through the valley of the shadow of death, and I will fear no evil, because thou art with me. Because you are always there. Because of your faithfulness, I am preserved. Because of your faithfulness, I am blessed. Because of your faithfulness, I am anointed. Because of your faithfulness, we become a blessing. We are blessed to be a blessing, O God. A blessing to your people. A blessing to the people around us. A blessing to the nation that we are in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. Oh, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Oh, we thank you that you are faithful. Faithful to the end. Faithful. Oh, shandela handa lishtikimbe. Riimla nushtaka andelin branushtaka mahande. Rimroshukumbra mahande lishtiki ande. Oh, rimbramoshu kumbra mahande. Li india mushu kumbra mahande limbra basande. Ri imla shundo kum la dishte kahan. Li inda rama sundo lunde dishte kim anda liya handashta. Ri induste mahande la dishte ka. Ri india masundo kum la egihiste mahande. Dimbioshu ko la mahande nishende. In the him unush amlana kanda rishte yahaka. Len mundos mahande. Li in the nina masu do kumble mina handa ishta. Li kinda nush the man de ni kunda lama nush the malakande. Li en inina handa nisht hadaka. Nim don dush do kumble meni in the yakande yuduste. Li in the hish andaka. Oh, le hamamande ni da nishta da.
Di indra as du kumbla mata nas de mende ruundo kumbla anda nishin da kande inde ruundo shundo unda mande limlandus do kumbla anda kimiene nas tunda linda rundo lombla nas de mahande le amblu shokunde rika alit de mat muste mande yanaka o la nishin de Lindishin day rahanda nushta ka linden munda nida nishta kanda nida munda lay handa. Olishin de kambra musundo. For you are faithful, you're faithful, you're faithful. Your faithfulness. Oh, we rest under your shadow. We rest under your protection. Oh, we prosper because you are faithful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, as we continue to walk in the path that you have designed for us, that you have appointed for us. We thank you for your faithfulness, that you're always there. Leading us, guiding us, protecting us, empowering us, anointing us. Oh, we thank you. Thank you for that empowerment of God. Oh, we thank you, Jesus, that as we walk, as we set our foot upon the places that you ask us to go, it will be blessed. In the name of Jesus, it will be blessed. It will be blessed because you are there with us. Oh, we thank you so much. Oh, do not doubt. Do not doubt the call that God has for you. Because His faithfulness will see you through. Do not doubt His promises to you, because His faithfulness will see you through. He's faithful. He has given His life for you and me. He is faithful. Do not doubt the call. Do not give up on that walk. Stand up, my dear brother and sister. Stand up. Let's continue. Let us hold hands. Let's continue to walk the path that God has set for us. Do not give up, because He is faithful. 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 Heavenly Father, we lift up those brothers and sisters of ours. There's a need of your touch right now. Your healing touch, O God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we thank you that by the stripes and by the wounds of Jesus, they are healed. Yes, you are healed by the stripes and by the wounds of Jesus. We take hold of God with divine healing and we speak it upon them in the name of Jesus. You are healed by His stripes and by His wounds. You're healed. Take a hold of that, declare it, claim it. Tell it to the nations. Tell it to the face of the enemy. Tell it to everybody. You are healed because my God is faithful. Because the God we serve is faithful. If He says that you are healed, then you are healed. You are healed. Oh, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we lift up our senior pastor to you. Lift up Pastor James to you, God. Thank you, God, that you continue to bless him. Lord, as he continue to serve you, as he continue to walk the path that you have set before him, we pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that your blessing and your provision and your anointing will continually overflow in his life, God. Lord, we thank you that he is blessed to be a blessing. We thank you
that he is in perfect health. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for open doors. Open doors, open doors, open doors for him, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord Father, I also lift up CLC to you, Covenant Life Church Indonesia. I lift them up all to you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, as those of us that are joining here in prayer, I pray in the name of Jesus that you bless them abundantly in the name of Jesus. To bless them. That you grant their heart's desire, oh God. I pray and I ask in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your love. Thank you, Father. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Father, this we give thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. Once again, this is Pastor Robert of Covenant Life Church Indonesia. And you are watching our Sunday service. And we have just done our morning prayer. But I urge you to stay with us. Join us in our praise and worship. And then listen to what the Lord has for you this morning. Again, thank you so much. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone. Oh, mm-hmm.
CLC.
Selamat pagi, CLC.
This is a rather unique morning. I'm talking to you from my hotel lobby.
Pagi ini agak unik karena saya bicara kepada Anda dari lobi hotel saya.
Just because of where I am, this is the best place I could talk to you. But
karena keberadaan tempat saya, maka inilah tempat yang terbaik di mana saya bisa bicara dengan Anda. Tetapi
anytime I can talk to you, anytime we can come together as a family to talk about God's word and God's spirit, it is a good time.
Setiap kali saya bisa bicara pada Anda, setiap kali kita bisa berkumpul sebagai keluarga membicarakan firman Tuhan, itu adalah waktu yang baik.
So I actually prepared for this trip because I brought from home our communion elements so that we can have proper communion elements today.
Jadi saya sengaja membawa dari rumah elemen perjamuan kudus supaya kita bisa bersama-sama bersatu dalam perjamuan.
So I want to encourage you wherever you are now as I'm saying hello to everybody, go and get your elements so that we can have communion together as a family.
Jadi sementara saya menyapa Anda, silahkan Anda mencari elemen supaya kita bisa mengadakan perjamuan kudus bersama-sama sebagai sebuah keluarga.
You know, on one hand, I don't like the restrictions that we have.
Di satu sisi, saya tidak suka dengan pembatasan karena COVID ini.
But on the other hand, I'm thankful to God that even with these restrictions, you and I can still meet and share from God's word in this manner.
Tapi di sisi lain, saya tetap bersyukur kepada Tuhan karena walaupun situasi COVID, kita tetap bisa bertemu dengan cara ini.
Now I know I heard that the government in Indonesia has said that there is a resurgence of COVID, that it is picking up with a new strain is what they're telling me.
Saya tahu bahwa pemerintah Indonesia sudah menyatakan bahwa ada peningkatan dengan pandemi COVID karena ada varian baru yang muncul.
But CLC, I remind you.
Tapi CLC, saya mengingatkan Anda.
On the basis of God's word,
berdasarkan firman Tuhan,
I am declaring every day,
saya deklarasikan setiap hari,
that CLC will not lose anyone to COVID.
Bahwa CLC tidak akan kehilangan siapapun karena COVID.
If you are young, I'm talking to you. If you are middle-aged, I'm talking to you. If you are older, I'm talking to you. If you are a child, I'm talking to you.
Kalau Anda seorang anak, saya bicara pada Anda. Anda remaja, saya bicara pada Anda. Dewasa, saya bicara pada Anda. Kalau Anda lansia, saya juga bicara kepada Anda.
That in the name of Jesus, CLC will not lose anyone to any form, new strain, new variation, or whatever variation. We're not losing anyone to COVID in Jesus' name.
Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus, CLC tidak akan kehilangan siapapun jemaatnya, apakah karena varian baru atau varian lama atau apapun itu, CLC tidak akan kehilangan satupun jemaatnya.
And I challenge you daily now, let your words join with my words and agree with me and say the same thing, that not only will your family not lose any to COVID, but CLC, the CLC family will not lose any because we have the same spirit of faith.
Karena itu saya menantang Anda supaya perkataan Anda itu sama dengan perkataan saya dan sama dengan firman Tuhan, yaitu bahwa kita tidak akan kehilangan siapapun karena kita memiliki roh iman yang sama.
These elements we hold in our hand.
Perjamuan yang kita pegang di tangan kita ini
are not just for show, not just for tradition, not just because we want to do something before the service.
Bukanlah merupakan sebuah pertunjukan, bukan juga tradisi atau karena kita mau melakukan sesuatu sebelum mendengarkan khotbah.
These elements we hold in our hand are a symbol of what Jesus Christ has done for you and me.
Perjamuan yang kita pegang di tangan kita ini adalah simbol daripada apa yang Tuhan Yesus sudah lakukan untuk Anda dan saya.
And because of what Jesus has done for you and me.
Dan karena apa yang Tuhan Yesus sudah lakukan untuk Anda dan saya itu,
we can have life and have it more abundantly.
Kita bisa punya hidup dan hidup yang penuh dengan kelimpahan.
So Jesus on the night that he was betrayed,
Jadi Tuhan Yesus pada malam ketika beliau dikhianati,
bread.
Ia mengambil roti.
He took bread.
Ia mengambil roti.
He blessed the bread.
Ia memberkati roti itu.
The bread.
And
he said, "This is my body broken for you."
Dan ia berkata, "Inilah tubuhku yang dipecahkan bagi kamu."
Often as you do this.
Setiap kali engkau melakukannya.
Well, Jesus didn't say this, but I'm reminding you. As often as you do this, we remember that his body was broken for us.
Tuhan Yesus tidak mengatakan hal ini, tapi saya mengatakannya. Setiap kali kita melakukannya, ingatlah bahwa tubuh Tuhan Yesus Kristus itu sudah terpecahkan untuk kita.
Let's partake of this together in Jesus' name.
Mari ambil bagian dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
And then Jesus, in the same manner of thanksgiving.
Dan dengan cara pengucapan syukur yang sama.
He took bread, he took the cup after supper.
Tuhan Yesus mengambil cawan sesudah makan.
He said, "Now this cup represents the new covenant in my blood."
Cawan itu darahku. Betapa lebihnya lagi di perjanjian baru kita. Kesembuhan dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
If in the old covenant they had protection, in you see that the children of Israel were protected in Pharaoh's in Egypt, how much more is there protection for you in the new covenant?
Kalau di perjanjian lama kita lihat umat Israel itu dilindungi dari Firaun, dari Mesir, betapa lebihnya lagi kita yang ada di dalam perjanjian baru. Yes.
Protection for you in Jesus' name.
Ada perlindungan untuk Anda dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
And healing for you in Jesus' name. Let's partake of this together. Amen.
Mari ambil bagian dalam nama Tuhan Yesus. Amin.
Father, thank you for the body and the blood.
Bapa, tubuh dan darah Tuhan Yesus.
It is life, it is health, it is mercy, it is goodness.
Itu adalah kehidupan, kesembuhan, kesehatan, kebaikan dan rahmat kasih Tuhan. Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, as I already told you in case you haven't heard.
Sebagaimana sudah saya beritahu kalau Anda belum mendengarnya.
I'm in a hotel, the hotel lobby.
Saya sedang berada di sebuah lobby hotel.
Hey. Tristan just came downstairs for breakfast.
Yeah. Hey guys.
Hi.
This
Anna
is
saya, not Tristan planned. Baru saja turun.
Yeah, I was just getting
This is not planned actually. I just saw him coming down for breakfast, so I grabbed him.
Yeah.
Hi guys.
Hello.
All right, go.
Okay.
Tidak direncanakan, dia baru saja lewat, jadi saya undang untuk mengucapkan halo.
This is the best place we could do it. For the recording with you all this morning.
Ini adalah tempat sudut terbaik di mana kita bisa lakukan rekaman ini untuk Anda semua.
Come on. Our anchor verse for the year.
Ayo, ayat jangkar kita, tema tahunan kita untuk tahun ini.
And again, by now everyone should know this already because it is already July. Everyone should know our anchor verse for the year is 2 Corinthians chapter 4.
Dan sekali lagi karena ini sudah bulan Juli, maka semua orang harusnya sudah tahu bahwa inilah ayat tema tahunan kita, yaitu 2 Korintus 4
verse 13 is
ayat 13 berkata,
"And since we have the same spirit of faith."
Dan karena kita memiliki roh iman yang sama.
You and I have the same spirit of faith.
Anda dan saya, kita memiliki roh iman yang sama.
And the spirit of faith is stronger than the spirit of fear.
dan roh iman itu lebih kuat daripada roh ketakutan.
Do not allow for the world spirit of fear to overtake the spirit of faith that you have.
Jangan izinkan roh ketakutan yang dari dunia ini mengalahkan roh iman yang Anda miliki.
The spirit of faith is an overcoming spirit.
Roh iman itu adalah roh yang penak, roh penakluk.
You can overcome everything that is in the world.
Anda bisa menaklukkan apa saja yang dari dunia ini.
And that includes the spirit of fear of COVID.
Dan itu juga termasuk roh ketakutan karena COVID.
And so I am challenging you, CLC. God gave us this verse. Not only should you know this verse, you should have memorized it and you should be declaring it daily by now.
Karena itu saya menantang Anda, CLC. Tuhan sudah memberikan kita ayat ini. Bukan saja Anda harusnya sudah hafal, tapi Anda juga harus mendeklarasikannya setiap hari.
The spirit of faith is an overcoming spirit. The spirit of faith is how, as believers, we do anything and we receive everything.
Roh iman itu adalah roh penakluk. Roh iman, melalui roh iman itu kita menerima segala sesuatu dan menaklukkan segala
and
sesuatu.
No matter if it is Goliath, no matter if it is a mountain, no matter if it is a virus, the spirit of faith can overcome that in Jesus' name.
Tidak peduli yang kita hadapi itu Goliath atau gunung atau virus COVID, kita bisa kalahkan mereka semua dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
And I am challenging you again. Everything we talk about in church, everything we have discussed and studied and prayed and prophesied about.
Dan saya menantang Anda lagi, semua yang sudah kita pelajari di gereja, semua yang sudah kita lihat, semua ayat firman yang sudah kita tinjau, segala yang sudah kita perhatikan.
It is not only for the good times, it is also for the challenging times.
Semua itu bukannya untuk masa-masa yang baik, tapi juga dalam masa-masa yang berantakan.
You know, for many years, I told all of you, it's easy to say amen, hallelujah, when we are together in Setia Budi.
Sudah bertahun-tahun lamanya saya beritahu Anda, sekali berkata amin ketika kita semua sedang baik saja di Setia Budi.
But when we are separate like we are now, when it is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, that is when you need to exercise what you heard on Sunday.
Tetapi ketika kita sedang terpisah dari Senin, Selasa, sampai Jumat, itulah saatnya Anda harus mengaktifkan iman Anda, apa yang Anda dengar di hari Minggu.
CLC, this is the time more than ever before.
CLC, sekaranglah waktunya, lebih daripada sebelumnya.
Where you must allow for everything thing you have heard to rise up on the inside of you and declare it with the roar of the lion of the tribe of Judah.
Di mana Anda harus mengizinkan roh yang di dalam Anda itu mengaum dengan kuat menyatakan kebenaran firman Tuhan.
You might think, but Pastor, there is a new strain of the virus.
Anda mungkin mengatakan, Pastor, ini ada varian baru dari virus ini.
But God's word has not changed.
Tapi firman Tuhan tidak berubah.
God's spirit has not changed.
Roh Tuhan juga tidak berubah.
Your Father God has not changed.
Bapa Anda Tuhan di surga tidak berubah.
Nothing about God has changed. God is unchangeable. The virus can change, but God is unchangeable.
Tidak ada yang berubah dengan Tuhan. Virus mungkin bisa berubah-ubah, tapi Tuhan tidak pernah berubah.
And God is still Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that healeth you.
Dan Tuhan kita itu tetaplah Yehovah Rapha, yaitu Tuhan yang menyembuhkan engkau.
God is still El Shaddai, the God who will take care of you financially and provide for you.
Tuhan tetaplah El Shaddai, yaitu Tuhan yang menyediakan segala sesuatu untuk Anda dan menyediakan keuangan untuk Anda.
And now more than ever before, CLC, this is the time when we must allow for the Spirit of God on the inside of us to rise up strong in Jesus' name.
Dan sekarang tibalah saatnya CLC, kita harus mengizinkan roh iman yang ada di dalam kita itu untuk keluar dengan kuat.
And every message you've ever heard, and if you tell me, oh, I've forgotten the messages, you can go to the Facebook page, you can go to YouTube or wherever and get those messages and hear them again.
Dan kalau Anda bilang Anda lupa dengan pesan yang sebelumnya, Anda bisa pergi ke Facebook, melihat YouTube, dan lihat lagi pesan-pesan yang ada di sana.
And you should, because it will feed you with faith.
Dan memang harusnya Anda lakukan demikian, karena itu akan memberi makan iman Anda.
The promises of God have not changed.
Janji Tuhan tidak berubah.
And I'll tell you, our God has not changed.
Dan saya beritahu, Tuhan kita tidak berubah.
But the situations around us have changed.
Nah, situasi sekitar kita mungkin berubah.
But God hasn't changed.
Tapi Tuhan tidak berubah.
And I'm challenging you now, CLC. This is the time. This is the perfect timing to stand up as believers and start demonstrating the spirit of faith.
Dan inilah saatnya, CLC, untuk kita berdiri dengan teguh dan deklarasikan iman kita.
You know, when I was a kid growing up in the Assemblies of God Church, they used to sing a song, "Let God Arise and His Enemies Be Scattered."
Ketika saya masih muda dan ada di sebuah gereja, ada sebuah lagu yang mengatakan, "Biarlah Tuhan bangkit dan musuhnya dipecah belahkan."
And I tell you now, you can start declaring, "Let God arise in my situations and his enemies be scattered in Jesus' name."
Dan Anda juga bisa mengatakan yang hal yang sama, biarlah Tuhan bangkit dan musuh-musuh itu dihancurkan, dipecah belahkan.
I'm not saying that we deny the situations.
Saya tidak mengatakan untuk kita menyangkal fakta situasi sekitar kita.
But what does the spirit of faith do?
Tapi apakah yang dilakukan oleh roh iman?
Look at this now, 2 Corinthians 4. This is our verse. We've been talking about this the whole year. 2 Corinthians 4:13. And since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, we believe and therefore we speak.
Mari kita lihat 2 Korintus 4 ayat 13 ayat tema tahunan kita. Karena kita memiliki roh iman yang sama seperti ada tertulis, aku percaya, sebab itu aku berkata-kata.
The spirit of faith believes it and speaks it.
Roh iman itu percaya dan kemudian berkata-kata.
And I believe it that CLC will lose no one to COVID, and I'm speaking it every single day.
Saya percaya bahwa CLC tidak akan kehilangan siapapun, dan saya perkatakan hal itu setiap hari.
And I'm challenging you. You need to start saying the same thing because you also have the same spirit of faith.
Dan saya menantang Anda supaya Anda juga menyatakan hal yang sama karena Anda memiliki roh iman yang sama juga.
And I'm challenging you. You need to stop speaking the fears and start speaking what you're believing God to do.
Dan saya katakan bahwa Anda harus berhenti bicara apa yang Anda takuti dan berkata-kata tentang iman yang ada di dalam hati Anda. Anda percaya apa yang Tuhan akan lakukan untuk Anda.
There is power in your words.
Ada kuasa dalam perkataan Anda.
Why? Because you have the same spirit of faith.
Mengapa? Karena Anda memiliki roh iman yang sama.
And in the same way that Jesus spoke to the fig tree in Mark 11 and cursed it and it died, you have that same spirit of faith also.
Dan sama seperti Tuhan Yesus yang mengutuki pohon ara di Markus 11, Anda juga memiliki roh iman yang sama.
And you need to start speaking every day, the protection of God is over my life, the protection of God is over my family, the protection of God is over my work. And not only is God protecting us, he's prospering us in Jesus' name.
Dan Anda juga harus memperkatakan setiap hari, perlindungan Tuhan ada padaku, perlindungan Tuhan ada pada keluargaku, pada bisnisku, dan bukan hanya itu, tapi Tuhan juga membuat aku menjadi makmur.
Let God be your God now.
Izinkanlah Tuhan menjadi Tuhan Anda sekarang.
Let God be your Father now.
Biarlah Tuhan menjadi Bapa Anda sekarang.
Not just when times are good, but when there are challenges, God is still your Father.
Tidak hanya ketika masa-masa itu adalah masa-masa yang baik, tapi dalam masa-masa penuh tantangan, biarlah Tuhan menjadi Bapa Anda.
And with everything in me, I am challenging you, CLC.
Dan dengan segala apa yang ada pada diri saya menantang Anda, CLC.
God can and God will provide for you. And God can and God will protect you.
Tuhan mampu dan Tuhan mau menyediakan untuk Anda. Tuhan mampu dan Tuhan mau melindungi Anda.
And now more than ever before, this is so important.
Dan sekarang lebih daripada sebelumnya, hal ini sangat penting.
That you understand.
Bahwa Anda mengerti.
That God is your God.
Bahwa Tuhan adalah Tuhan Anda.
And now more than ever before.
Dan lebih lagi daripada sebelumnya.
It's important we understand.
Penting untuk kita mengerti.
That even when times are challenging.
Walaupun dalam masa-masa yang penuh tantangan.
God will show up on your behalf.
Tuhan akan muncul atas nama Anda.
This morning.
Pagi ini,
as I got ready to come and talk to you,
sementara saya bersiap untuk berbicara kepada Anda,
I had such a sense of speaking the protection of God and speaking the healing of God over each and every one of you and us, me included, because I'm a part of the CLC family also.
Saya merasakan dorongan yang sangat kuat untuk memperkatakan perlindungan untuk Anda, perlindungan untuk CLC, termasuk untuk diri saya, karena saya juga termasuk bagian CLC.
And so before I say this, if you have never received Jesus as your Lord and as your Savior, this is a good day and a good time to receive Jesus as your Lord.
Sebelum saya memperkatakan hal itu, kalau Anda belum pernah menerima Tuhan Yesus sebagai Tuhan dan Juru Selamat pribadi, ini adalah yang baik untuk menerima Tuhan Yesus menjadi Tuhan dan Juru Selamat pribadi Anda.
John 3:16 says,
Yohanes 3 ayat 16 berkata,
God so loved the world.
Karena begitu besar kasih Tuhan kepada dunia ini.
That whosoever would believe on him would have eternal life.
Sehingga siapa saja percaya kepada dia and akan right memperoleh hidup yang kekal.
Right
tempat
where you are.
Anda berada.
I'm inviting you. This is the perfect day to come to Jesus.
Saya mengundang Anda, ini adalah hari yang sempurna untuk Anda menerima Tuhan Yesus.
So I want to encourage you, put your hand over your heart and repeat after me and repeat after our brother Roland.
Jadi saya mendorong Anda, taruh tangan Anda di atas dada Anda dan ikuti kata-kata saya dan penterjemah saya, Roland.
Father, I come before you now.
Bapa, aku datang kepadamu sekarang.
Now make sure you're repeating after us.
Pastikan Anda mengulangi kata-kata kami.
Father, I come before you now.
Bapa, aku datang kepadamu sekarang.
And I receive Jesus as my Lord and as my Savior.
Dan aku menerima Tuhan Yesus sebagai Tuhan dan Juru Selamat pribadiku.
I take Jesus' sacrifice on the cross for me.
Aku mengambil pengorbanan Tuhan Yesus di atas kayu salib untuk aku.
And because I do,
dan karena saya melakukan hal itu,
I am now your son, I am now your daughter.
Sekarang aku adalah anakmu.
and as your child, all your benefits, Bapa.
Dan sebagai anakmu, maka semua manfaat daripadamu menjadi milikku.
Jesus name, amen.
Nama Tuhan Yesus, amen.
Now, if you have prayed that for the first time, I want you to reach out to us, write to us, let us know what has happened so that we can pray for you and send you some information.
Baru saja mengatakan doa itu untuk pertama kalinya, saya ingin menghubungi kami lewat segala jalur sosial media, memberitahu kami apa yang sudah terjadi.
Now this is the part of the service I wanted to come to. This is the part that I had on my heart to declare over you or everyone else this morning.
Sekarang tibalah saatnya untuk saya menyampaikan apa yang ada dalam hati saya untuk pagi ini.
And if you need healing, this is for you. If you need protection, this is for you.
Kalau Anda butuh kesembuhan, ini untuk Anda. Kalau Anda butuh perlindungan, ini.
Well, we're doing things a little bit different this morning, but that's okay. It's okay to be different and let God move and minister to us.
Kita lakukan hal yang sedikit berbeda pagi ini, tapi tidak apa-apa, karena biarkanlah Tuhan bergerak dengan bebas untuk kita.
But this morning I had this on my heart, CLC.
Tapi pagi ini ada dorongan dalam hati saya, CLC.
I want to declare Psalm 91 over each and every one of us.
Dan mendeklarasikan Mazmur 91 untuk setiap.
So I'm asking you, as I'm declaring this over you, at the end of every sentence, say amen.
Jadi saya di setiap akhir kalimat yang saya katakan, Anda berkata amin.
CLC, in the name of Jesus.
CLC, dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
You, and I'm declaring Psalm 91 now. You who dwell in the secret place of the Most High.
Engkau yang duduk dalam tempat rahasia dari Yang Maha Tinggi.
You will abide under the shadow of the Almighty God in Jesus' name.
Engkau akan tinggal di bawah naungan dari Tuhan Yang Maha Kuasa dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
You will say of God, He is my refuge and my fortress. In God, I will trust.
Engkau akan berkata kepada Tuhan, tempat perlindunganku dan kubu pertahananku, Tuhanku yang kupercayai.
Surely, God will deliver us from the snare of the fowler and from perilous pestilence. God will deliver you.
Sungguh dan pasti Tuhan akan melepaskan engkau dari jerat penangkap burung dan dari penyakit sampar yang busuk. Tuhan akan melepaskan engkau.
He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wing you will take refuge in Jesus' name.
Tuhan akan menudungi engkau dengan paknya dan di bawah sayapnya engkau akan berlindung nama Yesus.
His truth shall be your shield against every lie and every dart of the enemy.
Kesetiaannya adalah akan menjadi perisai daripada setiap serangan semua.
You will not be afraid of the terror of night.
Engkau tidak usah takut terhadap teror dari malam hari.
Nor the arrows that shoot in the daytime.
Juga terhadap panah yang di waktu siang.
Hey, not of the pestilence or the virus that comes at night in Jesus' name.
Juga tidak perlu takut terhadap penyakit sampar atau segala virus yang berjalan di dalam gelap.
Nor of the destruction that comes at noonday.
Juga terhadap penyakit menular yang mengamuk di waktu petang.
See, listen to this. I'm declaring this over you. 1,000 will fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you in Jesus' name.
CLC, dengar. Walau 1,000 orang rebah di sisimu dan 10,000 di sebelah kananmu, tapi itu tidak akan menimpamu dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
Only with your eyes you will see the reward of the wicked, because God will protect you.
Engkau hanya menontonnya dengan tangan sendiri dan melihat balasan terhadap orang fasik, sebab Tuhan adalah tempat perlindunganmu.
This is the part I want to come to. Listen. No evil will fall on you in Jesus' name.
Dan bagian ini yang ingin saya katakan, malapetaka atau kejahatan akan God will give engkau.
God will give his angels to protect you and charge you.
Tuhan akan mengirim malaikat-malaikatnya untuk menjaga engkau.
Listen, listen, listen now, and this is what I'm going to end it with. You will call on him and he will answer you.
Dengar-dengar, inilah bagian ini saya akan akhiri. Engkau akan berseru memanggil Tuhan dan Tuhan akan God menjawab engkau.
God is with you in trouble.
Tuhan engkau dalam segala kesesakan.
And CLC, in the name of Jesus, I am declaring with a long life, he will satisfy you.
Dan CLC, dalam nama Tuhan Yesus, aku nyatakan bahwa dengan panjang umur, Tuhan akan memuaskan engkau.
CLC, God will protect you and guide you.
CLC, akan melindungi engkau dan menuntun engkau.
Now, on the screen right now is information on how you can send your tithes and your offerings.
Di layar Anda sekarang ada informasi tentang bagaimana Anda bisa mengirim persembahan puluhan Anda.
And as you give, believe God.
Dan ketika Anda percaya Tuhan.
Give with gratitude, give with honor, and give with faith.
Berilah dengan rasa, berilah dengan rasa hormat dan dengan iman.
CLC, remember, God CLC, says with long life, he'll prosper and honor you.
CLC, ingatlah bahwa Tuhan berkata dengan panjang umur, Tuhan akan mengenyangkan engkau.
Remember that the spirit of faith daily believes and speaks.
Ingat bahwa roh iman itu setiap hari percaya dan berkata-kata.
I am speaking.
Aku berkata-kata.
I am believing.
Aku percaya.
You do the same thing.
Engkau lakukan hal yang sama.
Let me pray for you before I let you go.
Mari saya doakan Anda sebelum kita berpisah.
Father, as we have given, it is given unto us.
Bapa, sebagaimana kami sudah memberi, akan diberikan kembali kepada kami.
Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, men will come and pour into you.
Takaran yang baik padakan digoncang dan tumpah keluar, manusia akan menuangkannya kepadamu.
And I declare this over you, the Lord bless you and keep you.
Dan aku nyatakan ini kepadamu, Tuhan memberkati engkau dan melindungi engkau.
The Lord make his face shine upon you. There will always be light in your life.
Tuhan menyinari engkau dengan wajahnya, akan selalu ada terang dalam hidupmu.
The Lord be gracious, be kind, be merciful to us.
Dan Tuhan memberi engkau kasih karunia, Tuhan memberikan engkau kasih sayangnya kepadamu.
Lord, lift up his countenance upon us.
Tuhan menghadapkan wajahnya kepada kita.
And the Lord give you this, nothing broken, nothing lost, everything complete.
Dan Tuhan memberikan kita yang tidak hilang, yang tidak terpecahkan, yang segalanya utuh.
Shalom, peace.
Yaitu damai, shalomnya.
Amen, amen, amen. Be blessed, have a power. Amen. Remember, the spirit of faith believes and speaks.
Diberkatilah engkau dan ingat, roh iman itu percaya dan berkata-kata.
Amin.
Amin.